Hi. Peekaboo.
Hello.
Hey guys, welcome. It's Friday, huh? Friday. Time to get crazy and wild and enjoy the upcoming events and weekends and everything else. Hey, juice day number 13. Baker's dozen, huh? There you go. Yeah, just thought I'd start off being a little silly and stuff, in a good mood. Happy to be Friday. What else out there to say? I didn't go for a walk yesterday. Leg was still pretty hurting. I probably pushed it a little bit too much on Wednesday. I walked pretty much up and down the hall, it seemed like, for a mile there yesterday, trying to stretch it out and stuff. It feels a lot better today, so plan on probably maybe getting out there, maybe taking the kids. I took my daughter to the park yesterday, which was fun. I was gonna take my little man, but he was taking a nap, so you don't wake a sleeping bear. Yeah, that so I got some time in the park and running around. Well, not running around. Walking around and enjoying with her. Sammy had a good time. Got to be sun came down, took her home. Went to my buddy's house and we're sitting there and thinking about it. And 35 years old, and both looked like you realized. I said, "You ever think that would be 35 years old and our night would be sitting around having some juice they just made and watching the Big Bang Theory and Community and different kind of shows here for Thursday night?" About the only time I really care to watch TV has got some good shows on there. But we sat around there, had a good conversation, and talked about stresses and talked about everything, basically covered about if you're ready to go back and eat regular food. And I said it's probably a personal challenge of mine is to make sure that I keep going on this juice until I physically have my mind straight and ready to go. I feel strong right now, but I think it's just easy as like coordinated with like smoking, which I did for many years of my life. And I quit two different times. First time I quit, I went for 5 years and then got off it. And then when I lost the death of my father and stuff, I used that as an excuse. And before I know it, 5 years of not touching a cigarette and that stuff, and I was smoking a pack a day in less than a week, That's how it ticks in there. And I correlate that with food, basically. Food can be the exact same way. If I get off this and I want to think about, oh, just have a piece, a slice of pizza or something like that, well, what stops me from going that two slices of pizza to three slices of pizza to four, or half a pizza, the whole thing, the whole pizza's gone, It challenges. That's why I want to incorporate, I want it, my personal goals too is never to have pop again. Been 13 days without it and I feel great. I see the benefits already. Sleeping through the night, not drinking that stuff, and it is a diuretic, so it dehydrates you, makes you want to drink more, and you drink more and more of that stuff. Literally, I mean, at the end here and that stuff, you drink one of those. They got those liter bottles now and that stuff, and I would drink one of those, no problem. Sometimes even that and something else, 20 ounce or another half, another one, and a crutch of that. Snickers is a great crutch of mine. Reese's peanut butter cups are just not a crutch of mine. And you get I want to make sure that I'm able to control those fights and stuff, and I want to work hard, but as of right now I don't want to incorporate any of that stuff into my life, just for the simple fact that I don't want to be it getting me back into the addiction of going towards it. I wish there was actually somewhere around here that was like Overeaters Anonymous or something like that, which I think would actually be a cool thing to get a group on there. Even thinking of ways to get a group together or something, because there is more people out there and just watching the videos, but want the one-on-one and hear the closeness of relationship with the one-on-one with the person. But outside of that, this is pretty much my class, the way to blab it all out there and get it out there and tell you my side of it. But yeah, like I said, I brought it up there, and it was a good conversation. I should actually pull a camera and record it as we talk, so get more in there, but I got to get used to that to actually think, oh, pull out the camera and, you know, record this. I don't know if my buddy would want it on that, but I don't think he would have mind, but it would have been a nice thing, so he could kind of show what we're talking about. But, you know, and he said, I agreed with him. He said, he goes, there's no way we, he goes, he said at one point that we could basically walk out of this house, hop in the vehicle, and go down to anywhere and have a great, great meal and all that stuff. It try to be healthy and stuff, but it won't be cooked the way you need to, or be unhealthy and stuff, or grab the, you know, most delightful bakery item that you want to see and this stuff. But my mind is slowly changing that it's not worth it for me, and it's not what I want anymore. I don't want that because of the regret and the what I need to, what I get out of it. Does it satisfy my needs for a little bit? Maybe a little bit it does, yes. But I don't have just a little bit of that item, you know? I mean, literally sit down and I have a pizza, and like my daughter even said the other day, she goes, you love pizza. And I said, I do. Pizza's one of my crutches. And I would order pizza up, and then pretty much ordered up a pizza for me and a pizza for the kids, you know? And thinking about that, is, you know, it's disgusting, but these facts have to be said out there. There's no reason to hide behind it, because I'm not... you get the stresses and that stuff, but I consumed way too much, you know. I just get down there. You don't get this size by not consuming. You can't, you know, you can be as to say, oh, I don't eat that much and that stuff. Well, that's baloney. I mean, yeah, there'd be times out that stuff, but I would wake up and I don't have breakfast, and I would go to the following day, and I would have in the afternoon, and all of a sudden I'd start eating there, and I'd have a big, big meal for that, a couple of helpings, whatever it may be. If I had a sandwich, it always had to be two sandwiches. If I ordered out food, it would be a meal plus another sandwich or something like that. And if it was, you know, go out to, you know, eat and that stuff, you know, and if fajitas, like El Mariachi's, love Mexican food. And you'd have, I'd go to El Mariachi's and get the Texas fajitas or the mixed fajitas or whatever fajitas and that stuff. And they, I mean, it's helping. I look at that, I'm like, oh my God, I can't. My mind's even wrapping around, how did I eat all that stuff to begin with? But I would eat literally all that stuff with rice and the fixings of putting lettuce, guacamole, and sour cream and all this stuff and that, you know. And I would eat that down. I wouldn't think nothing about it. And I look around there and I, you know, see that people would... I now I think if we'd actually go there, I see no reason why both my wife and I can't order up fajitas, and one portion that's supposed to be for one person, as they say, can't be for just the two of us, and that'd be great. Plenty. I don't think I'd even get through two of those right now if we wanted to, which is great. I think I realize that stuff where I've gone wrong, but in no way that I'm ready to get off this fast by any means, because there's still a lot of rebuilding, still a lot of, you know, years, and I think just like smoking and all that stuff, that you could be just easy to get off this and say, yeah, I've done great. I've lost, you know, 20, 30 pounds, whatever the weigh-in is, 10 pounds and stuff. I've lost 50 pounds total. I've done good. I haven't. I can't say I've done good until I am below 300 pounds. There's just no way. You know, even at heart, I'm proud and happy with every weight loss and what I do with the journey, but I am focused. I am focused more than now than ever to doing the right thing and choosing the right stuff. But, you know, if it helps understand the people out there that it can't hide behind basically thinking that I'm a modest eater or anything else, because it's a lie. It is an absolute 100% lie, because the fact of the matter is, no matter what you do, the habits out there haven't been ingrained in the way I was brought up. I was brought up, we ate supper at the table, everybody joined around there, but I'm also 6-7 years apart from my brother and sister. When my sister 18, she graduated from high school, she got moved on, and she moved out of the house. My brother moved out right away, and I was left there. Well, my mom, when I was about 10 years old, this all happened on there and this stuff. And my mom wanted to choose to move on with, get out of the house and move on with her career, which is great. And she took care of it. And she went full four, and she was working nights and that stuff. And all of a sudden, suppers at the table didn't become that often. And then there was a lot more incorporated with bringing home fast food or pizza joints and that stuff. And that's the way I was brought up. On the country, it'd be something quicker. And I worked on the farm and get home and do chores, go down to the farm and stuff. We'd come up. And I remember towards the end there, as I got, you know, close to older, 16 and above there, if they brought up food, I remember it was just the three of us. And say Dad would make steaks on the grills or whatever and that stuff. She'd make these three steaks that were, you know, ribeye steaks that were literally like, you know, that big of steaks. Wouldn't make just three of them, one for everybody. Wouldn't make six of those and put them out there. And you'd eat a couple steaks with portions and everything else, with french fries and salads and all that stuff. So, I mean, looking at it as basically growing up this way. And the big challenge for me is to realize that I'm incorporating that same way I brought up. And that's why I'm doing that to my family. So I want to change that. We sit around and we have a healthy lifestyle, healthy dinner. And the only way I change them is I got to change me. Excuse me. But, yeah, you know, and I guess it was built that way or something like that. Because my brother and my sister, you know, beautiful people. They're healthy, you know, for the most part. They do have smoking habits. I wish they'd quit. But they have, you know, they're, you know, decent-sized people and that stuff. Overweight, not really at all, and tall and stuff. And I never built that way. And I think it looks a lot on that as the way I was brought up on getting used to this stuff. And it is a crutch and addiction, you know. And I think you can get overweight from eating food. But when you're ingrained to use the fast food and have that easier, which a society has become used to, and that stuff is, those foods are totally wrong, and you can gain up there. And I see my daughter going up in weight and that stuff, and I don't want her to get the same way as me or deal with the struggles. And I don't want her to be 35 years old making YouTube videos at this. I want her to make 35 year old make YouTube videos on healthy stuff and how she stays right and fit, you know. And I think I can do that. But yeah, this might be a long rant and stuff, but it's Friday. I'm happy. You know, made it to the end of the week here, 13 days, and we're going off. And, what else to say? I guess I just got a message on my computer. My buddy's just making fun there. But, I totally threw me off track right now. But I want to, you know, congratulate everybody else who's been watching that stuff and enjoying the journey. And people are going to start this weekend or start it today, or you got plans. It's great. I'm supporting all you guys out there. This has been a great, great journey so far. And it's a long journey ahead. And that's what I look forward to, is the end results. But, yeah, outside of that, thanks for watching. Sorry I blabbed on for so long. But enjoy your Friday out there. Have a great weekend, and we will see you tomorrow, hopefully. I'll try to keep a daily vlog, otherwise, like, I'll do like I did there and wrap up the weekend and have video and that stuff. But it gets to be long if I do all that stuff. But I can talk for very long, I guess, right now, too. So, otherwise, bye-bye!